honored to be here with Pascal from Gatehouse Grill.
Good morning. Good morning. Thank you.
I am excited about your recipe today. We're doing scallops with a Southwest cornbread dressing, and it's got layers, so we better get started.
Absolutely.
Layers.
The first thing we have to do is prepare our cornbread. It's a quick and easy recipe, as you have. We start with our wet and dry ingredients, putting in all our dry ingredients.
May I? Baking soda, flour, sugar.
And cornmeal, of course. Now we have our wet ingredients. A little buttermilk, one egg, and a small amount of butter. You would treat this like you would any pasta, just stirring enough till it all comes together. There you go.
All right. All right, and may I ask, why buttermilk?
It has a great tang to it. When you're dealing with seafood, you want tang. You want something to cut through that seafood-like quality, and buttermilk works very well for that.
Now that's fully incorporated.
Yes, and we have a prepared dish sprayed with a little bit of pan spray.
May I tell the audience, this is very important. I do not want your cornbread sticking.
And our baking temperature is 350.
But how long?
About 15, 20 minutes. When to the touch, when it springs back, you know it's done.
Let's get started on that stuffing, that dressing.
Of course.
For this, one of the many levels of this recipe. I just love it.
Very good. Then now that we have our cornbread prepared, we can start sauteing our vegetables. We'll start off with a little bit of clarified butter, add our onions. You know, it takes just minutes. We just want these to soften up and get nice and rounded. We'll come in with our garlic.
Never too much garlic.
Not in this recipe. And we're fortunate in this area to have corn, ripe for meat and beautiful corn, which will add to this.
You took this right off the, you shucked this yourself.
Yes, I did.
I could tell.
Yes, I did. Now we'll add a few more vegetables, our celery, carrots, and a couple of little surprises here. A little poblano pepper, which I've grilled, seeded, and cut. And it adds a nice, soft, smoky flavor to it all.
I love that. I love that smoky. I'm adding all of this. Is that okay?
That's great.
All right.
And finally, we'll finish the dish with 2 ounces of venison sausage.
Well, let's get that sausage in there. All right.
Good.
What he did was you just took the casing off.
Yes,
okay?
Exactly.
All right, that's good. Is it a spicy venison or?
What it adds more than anything else is a wonderful gaminess.
Ooh.
And when you think of a product like this, it's not the gaminess, but the way that they make meats now, the wild game, they're very soft and rounded. And we're fortunate to have at the Great House, at the Gatehouse Grill, these products that we can serve to our customers.
And another thing I love about the Gatehouse Grill is it's casual. It's comfortable.
It is.
And you really work on the service end of it.
Very much so. Our service persons are well trained. I want them to use the right words, the right language, the right flavors to describe to our customers what they're having for the evening.
Well, I think I'm all sauteed out here.
Very good, then.
Tell me next, Chef.
Now we'll add our cornbread.
All right.
And we'll just give that a simple toss.
Okay. Okay, here we go. You ready?
Yes.
Oh, this is really feeling good to me.
Now we'll add a little salt and pepper and dried oregano.
Dried oregano it is, and just a pinch. It's dried. Salt, any special? Looks like kosher, sea?
It is sea salt.
Sea salt. I'm
and we're going to finish it off with a little chicken broth.
Hey,
just to moisten it all up.
Oh, maybe that's enough.
That's beautiful.
That's beautiful. Now, can I see that pepper mill over there.
Oh,
fresh ground black peppers.
Exactly.
Yes, would you mind?
Not at all, dear.
Fresh is best. That is
there
just great.
Go.
Thank you so much. I'm looking forward to putting all this together.
And can that smell, isn't that wonderful?
And the color.
Exactly.
The color is beautiful, and how well this is going to work with the sweetness of those scallops.
Exactly. For an appetizer, you don't want too much food. 2 to 3, about 2 ounces per serving. We'll season them with a little sea salt, fresh cracked pepper, and pan sear them off in a little bit of olive oil. The thing about scallops is that Overdoing them could be the worst thing ever. So as far as the cooking time, I suggest 2 to 3 minutes on one side, and then I turn them over, turn the heat off, and let them finish themselves.
Thank you, that sounds good, and you are right. So many people overcook those sea scallops, so that is the best thing we can teach you today is don't overcook these. Get that caramelization, put it in a hot pan, and that's how you work with these sea scallops. I love how that chipotle sauce just brings the whole dish together.
And would you call it memorable?
This dish is memorable. And I thank you, Pascal, from my heart for being here today.
Well, thank you, dear. Thank you. Gatehouse Grill, 8220 Main Street. Come dine with me, Western New York.